There it is. Snowing, snowing, snowing. Now, that's global warming for you, isn't it, James?
That's great. Skiing in June in Scotland. It's great for the tourist industry. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. And then we'll get to the other extreme, that at some point this summer, we'll get a mini heat wave and our media will bombast saying it's a
Britain's
meltdown.
Britain's on fire.
And then they'll have the maps that it's all covered in some sort of inferno colours. And we've all got to stay safe and stay indoors rather than getting vitamin D. Remember that?
Yes.
The whole thing is catastrophizing. And actually, it's indicative of where we are with our discourse on so many topics. The public and punters out there, they're not stupid. They understand what's going on in their lives. And if they see something, and I'm trying not to swear here, because I was warned about that earlier, if they see something that's nonsense, then they're going to say that it's nonsense based on what they're doing in their own lives.
I'm going to, for the
Cairn Gorms in Scotland, I hope they get a good set of snow to get the chairlifts working in June.
Yeah, that guy there in the picture, apparently what he was saying at the time, he was saying, oh my God, this warmest ever spring is getting ridiculous. It seems to me that the Met Office, their key phrase is since records began, and then they try to work out things they can say before that. Every single time, since records began, since record, hottest, wettest, since records began, climate change. It seems to be an operation to prove or to get us to panic almost about climate change. And I think a more sensible, moderate approach would be preferable, don't you think?
I completely agree. I mean, you had one of our newspapers the other day, in the space of 24 hours, saying we're going to get 50 days of rain, and the next day saying we're going to have a meltdown heat wave. I think most people see through it. You know, we can see it literally from our own temperature about whether we have to wear a coat, whether we have to put the heating on. You know, maybe quote the words of Billy Connolly. There's no such thing as bad weather. Just get yourself a decent raincoat and live a little.
Yeah.
I think largely that's what the people in this country do, but they're not going to take this nonsense. Yes, the Met Office will find ways to justify those figures. We're not questioning, you know, some of their data, but is it consistent with previous records and in previous and certain locations to get that modelling? And then ultimately what happens from that is there's an overdrive in our media with bombast and scaremongering, but sadly, and this is the important bit, it reaches some dubious political decisions because of that narrative.
Absolutely. What's that phrase there? Lies, damn lies and statistics. You can make anything out of statistics, and I'm getting suspicious about the Met Office. Warmest spring ever. Yeah, right.